Welcome to our video guidelines for filling in the International Labor Migration Statistics, or ILMS, questionnaire. This video is produced through a collaboration between Statistics Korea and the International Labor Organization. The main purpose of this video is to present the practical steps to follow to properly fill in the ILMS questionnaire. A separate video presenting the concepts and structure of the ILMS questionnaire is also available. Let's get into it. This practical guideline is composed of three parts. In the first part, we will see how to access the ILMS questionnaire, and we will look into its main features. In the second part, we will highlight the main steps to follow to fill in the questionnaire properly. In the last part, we will discuss the questions frequently asked when filling in the questionnaire. First, let's see what the main features of the ILMS questionnaire are. To access the questionnaire, please follow the link that is provided in the email you received from the ILO, in which the ILO kindly asked your institution to take part in the ILMS data collection and therefore to complete the ILMS questionnaire. That link takes you to the ILMS questionnaire page. That page is country-specific and includes information on the other contact persons and organizations of your country, to which this data collection request was sent. In that page, you can also access the detailed user guide for reporting international migration statistics to the ILO. There, you can access and download the three Excel files which constitute the questionnaire. You can distinguish the three Excel files by their suffix. The name of the first one ends with BIR, as it covers the migrants defined, based on country of birth. The second file's name ends with CIT, as it covers the migrants defined based on country of citizenship. The third file's name ends with NAB, as it covers the nationals abroad. Let's look closer at the content of the downloaded Excel files. The first Excel file, the BIR file, where migrants are defined based on country of birth, includes two sheets. The first sheet is named MST and covers the international migrant stock indicators. That is to say, the indicator tables to be completed in that first sheet are international migrant stock indicator. The second sheet, named MFL, covers the international migrant inflow or incoming flow indicators. The content of the second file, the CIT file, is similar, the only difference being the definition of migrants based on country of citizenship. It also includes one sheet for stock indicators and another for inflow indicators. The third file includes indicators on nationals abroad, from stock of nationals living abroad to outflow or outgoing flow of nationals. In total, the full-length questionnaire comprises 35 indicators. Before we move forward, let's take a minute to highlight some technical features of the Excel files that are important to know to properly use them. The workbook is protected. Please do not add or delete any cell or row. Cells are color-coded. Dark yellow cells indicate drop-down menus from which you can select options. It can be a variable classification version, a type of data source, a geographical coverage, etc. Light yellow cells indicate that you are free to enter any text in those cells. It could be the survey name, the data, some notes, etc. The gray cells indicate columns dedicated to revised data that are optional. Please only fill in revised data columns for previously submitted data that you wish to correct. The Excel files will be uploaded into the ILMS back office system in an automated manner. Data consistency checks will be run by the system within and across tables and with previously submitted data. It is important not to modify the structure of the Excel file in order to allow the automated upload and checks. This slide shows the BIR Excel spreadsheet. As you can see at the bottom of the sheet, there are four tabs. The first one includes the instructions on how to fill in the tables. Please pay close attention to the instructions. The second tab gathers information on the sources of data. The third and fourth are dedicated respectively to the indicators on stock and flows of international labor migrants by place of birth. here's the page that appears when you click on the Source tab. As indicated at the top of the sheet, please fill in the source sheet information before you enter the data in subsequent sheets. The sheet requests you to report the details of each source of data reported in the file. First, you need to provide the specific name of the data source if it has not been pre-filled. In this case, the first data source used is the population census. After that, you need to specify the type of source if not already pre-filled. Then, please enter the required information on data reference period, geographical coverage, and population coverage. Please note that the information fields to be completed may vary according to the type of source selected. Make sure not to leave any field empty. Afterwards, please provide the name and email address of the contact person related to that data source. Here is an example page for the International Migrant Stock tab, or the MST tab. As you can see, the stock indicators are listed at the top of the page, and you can click on each indicator to access the related table to be filled. The indicator ID in the ILO stat database can be identified by the numbers in front of the indicator. This slide shows the International Migrant Flow, or MFL, sheet, whose format is similar to that of the MST page we just looked at. Let us move on to more detailed instructions on how to fill in the questionnaire. Here are 7 steps to follow to properly fill in the ILMS questionnaire. The first step is simple. Always start with the source sheet first. In the source sheet, as already mentioned previously, please review the pre-filled information if available. Correct that pre-filled information whenever it is necessary. Then complete the missing fields by selecting the relevant option in the drop-down menus. Please do not leave any field empty. Please make sure that all the elements in the source sheet are correctly completed before moving on to the next step. The source sheet must be completed in each Excel file, the BIR, the CIT, and the NAB file, even if the same data source is used in all files. That step will allow you to link each indicator table to the relevant data source afterwards. The next step is to enter data and relevant notes. Above each indicator table, there is a source field where you must select the source of the data reported in the table. Clicking on that field will show a drop-down menu where you will be able to select the relevant data source from the list of sources you previously entered in the source sheet. The yellow column is the column you must complete for the current data collection exercise. In our example, the data reference year in that column is 2018. You can click on the 2018 cell to select another year if you need to change the reference year. Only use the gray column when you need to revise already submitted data. Please type text only in designated light yellow fields to provide information such as details on sources, notes, and comments. When you enter data, please enter the actual number of persons, not a number in thousands or hundreds. This is because we need to ensure sufficient precision when calculating various kinds of figures. However, note that the number of migrants will be reported in thousands on ILO stat after processing. Please use the drop-down menu whenever you encounter a dark yellow cell. For example, when you like to change the reference year or to select the main countries of birth as shown in the current examples, or to select an economic activity classification, etc. Do not use the cut and paste function in the Excel files. Doing so will change the underlying structure of the file. It will make it unusable to be uploaded at ILO stat, and we will not be able to use the reported data. Please try to avoid empty tables. Although, if for a given indicator there is no data related to migrants, that is to say, no data on foreign-born or non-citizens, please do not enter information in the table. The fact that a specific indicator is not available in your country is also valuable information. However, in that situation, please leave the table empty, including the source field and the box for notes at the bottom of the table. It is not necessary to specify in the note box that data is not available. If for a given indicator you have multiple data sources available, please enter the data from each source in separate Excel files. For example, if working-age population data is available from both the census and the labor force survey, you must enter the data from the census in one Excel file and the data from LFS in a second Excel file. Each Excel file must provide the specific name and details of the data source. It is not necessary to complete the information for other indicators in the additional Excel file when they do not have multiple data sources. Before you submit the Excel sheets, please perform basic checks to ensure data consistency. You must ensure that values are consistent across the different tables. For example, Table 1078 provides the working age population by age. Table 1089 provides the working age population by education. When you sum up the population over the age categories in the first table, or over the education categories in the second table, the result should be the same, as there is only one total working age population. It is the same for the total number of foreign born. It should be the same total value across the different tables where the number of foreign born are disaggregated according to age, education, or country of birth. It is also the same for total employment, total employment of foreign born, etc. Within each table, please ensure that the different categories add up to the total value. In a table with sex disaggregation, the sum of male and female value should be equal to the value provided for both sexes. In a table with place of birth disaggregation, the sum of foreign born, native born, and status unknown value must be equal to the value provided for the total category. It is also the same for tables with age disaggregation, education disaggregation, or any other disaggregation variable. Also, please make sure that the order of magnitude of values makes sense. The working age population must be the same or greater than the number of employed population. The total value in any given table must be greater than the value of each category of the table. Now, let's address some frequently asked questions. Is labor force survey, or LFS, a suitable data source? Yes. Labor force surveys are a good source of data on labor market information related to migrants and non-migrants. Shall we prioritize LFS as a source? And if LFS data is not available, can we use administrative registers data? If data from multiple sources are available, please provide all data from all sources. For that process, please use multiple Excel files as explained in Step 6. What is the working age to report if we collect data for 15 to 74? If data are available for 15 to 74 years old, please report data for this age range. What are the criteria for choosing the 5 specific countries to report in tables 1080 and 1081? Table 1080 relates to non-citizens by sex and country of citizenship, and Table 1081 relates to foreign-born by sex and country of birth. The 5 countries to report on are the main or top 5 countries of citizenship, or top 5 countries of birth, those from where most of the migrant populations come from. We do not have data for the survey reference year. Can we provide less recent year's data instead? Please provide the most recent data available if they have not yet been submitted to the ILO. Can we submit data in a different format? No. The ILO Stat back office system can only read information from the Excel questionnaires. Any information provided in any other format will not be usable. We have now reached the end of this practical guideline on ILMS questionnaire. For any questions, please contact us at ILMS_quest@ilo.org. Thank you.